Good morning everybody, Evert here. Predator Tour 2019 is close to start. Behind me you see the harbor, there will be the morning inspections. We will inspect the boats if they have the safety equipment and it's all safe to start, and especially if they all have the right equipment. We do the inspections and we will take care of that the participants are safe. So today is the first day, all the participants are coming to the inspection area and we are ready for them. We do the boat inspection and around 8 o'clock we will start and day one is a fact. So thanks for watching, and for you all guys, be the best, catch the biggest.
So today is the first day of Predatortour 2019. Everybody's really excited, boat checks all done, everything sorted. We've got the boards, all the stickers have been put on the boards, specific barcodes for the day. A little bit windy, so it's going to be a wet run where we're planning to go.
The weather is not very good, but you know, that's a handicap for all other competitors. And we know some spots where we have less trouble with the wind, and we will try to cope with that. But I'm confident.
I think it's a nice Irish weather today, so wind and rain is good for us.
The plan is now around the island. There's a little less wind. We have not such a big, very big boat, we have some trouble with the big waves. Safety first.
The competition format is 3 pike, 3 zander, and 3 perch. Our plan today is to try and get the pike done as early as possible. Then we can move on to the others. Ideally, we'd like to have the pike and the zander done on the first day, and then we've only got to hunt the perch. So it's critical that you get all 3 species on the board to get your 1,000 bonus points.
I'm pretty sure we'll be a lot of big fish because you have so much talent here, you know, all the best fishermen in Europe, actually, maybe in the world for pike are here, and we are so proud to be part of that, you know. Our goal is to not finish the last. So if you are the 119, we'll be happy.
Eerste vis, 68 centimeter.
Hartstikke idee.
Hoppa.
Lekker man.
Nice spot, hoor.
Dat is mooi, hoor.
Onze eerste.
We are here at the south of Tienge Meter on the lake Haringvliet, and we are surveying the boats who are fishing here, because there are some rules in this nature area, and some of the rules are you cannot drive harder than 9 km/h, and you have to you cannot fish behind the yellow marks. You can see the people fishing there. And I see 2 marks, and I see when I draw a line between it, I see them on the right side, and when they are on the left side, that's illegal, and then we have to say something or give them a yellow card or do what we have to do.
De eerste snoekbaars. 81, jongen. Dat zijn ze.
We got four pikes at least and one perch, and we try to get the perch full, and now we concentrate completely to the perch, and maybe when this will work, we got 2 days for three Zander, and that will be our plan today. We speak together, we don't check the leaderboard in the competition because we get nervous and be pissed off at the end. So we don't want to do that.
It's now 2 o'clock and it's also time for us to look at the leaderboard. Go to leaderboard and then we will see who's on the first place. What important is now is to see which teams have the 1,000 points, and that are the first 5 teams. That means they get a full card, so they get the 3 pikes, the 3 perch and the 3 zander. On the first place now with 1,588 centimeters, Lionel Chevalier and Tristan Poulin. And then they are followed with 1,487 points, so there's a difference of 100 points. On the second place, Gino Dorisi and Patrick Kriemler. And then on the third place, Chris Bloemert and Michel Lichthart. And I will look at the first, at Lionel Chevalier and Tristan Poulin. They have a pike of 111, so that's a good one. And then pikes around 70 centimeters. Then they have a Zander 65, 65 and 63. So that's our good Zanders. And then perch of 50, 47 and 46. So they have really, really, really big perches. So I think they have to upgrade the pike and the Zander. And they are in good position now, but they have to hold it for 2 days. So it will be exciting.
Really good, because we could get 5 fishes, we could get the 3 pikes and 1 zander and 1 perch, and then we want to catch more perch and more zander, but the motor was damaged.
Before 12 o'clock we had all the pike and perch completed, so we were extremely happy, and then all our zander spots didn't work, so the afternoon was a little bit disastrous, but We're gonna get that back tomorrow.
Today was for us quite hard because we have some small engine problems. So we only can go to 12 kilometers per hour. And yeah, with this weather condition and wind condition and waves condition, it was quite wet, I guess, and quite hard to make it.
The pikes were full in, I don't know, an hour or an hour and a half. So we started to go for Zander. And actually we struggled with the Zander, but we got loads of perch. So we have the pikes full, the perch full, and so now we're just looking for Zander.
Didn't go to plan, but we managed to catch a pike and 2 good Zander. So we feel going into tomorrow, we've got still got a good chance.
We had like 15 pikes.
Yeah, 15 pikes, something like that.
But only small ones. The perch was doing really good. We had a 50 centimeter perch. A 45 and a 44 perch. So tomorrow we go full on the Zander.
Hello everybody. Well, day one is a fact. We are now close to begin with the prize giving ceremony. If you have the app, the free app of our competition, it's downloaded already 14,000 times, so 14,000 downloads of our free app. You can see the leaderboard. Well, the French teams are dominating on the first day. The top three is all participants from France, so they did a really good job. And if you download the app, it's for free, like I said. You can see how much they caught and how many points they got. If you go in the app to the top catches of the day, we also have a prize giving for the biggest fish. A pike of 122, an enormous Zander of 94, and a monster perch of 52. When you open the app, you see the team who caught the fish, and tonight we will give away nice prizes for the best top three of the day. Thanks for watching and see you all tomorrow for day two.
But now too many rods, we have too many fishing gear, sheds, wobblers, crankbaits, and you name it.
A little bit of lure I need, because for fishing is very important. I have two or three rod, a little bit more, and I have two life jacket, because I need for my friend and me, and I have the keys for start the boat, and it's good.
Gear. I got everything, yeah. Batteries are charged, and I got some fuel in the tank, so that's cute. Fishing gear is okay, yeah.
Lures
also, yeah, everything. Do you need rods for fishing, actually?
Yesterday I fished the whole day with one shed, and there I caught four pikes, so.
So as I counted quickly, you brought something like 4,000 sheds, and you only fished with one yesterday.
Yes, you can say that, yeah.
We are the team 32, and at the end of the first day we are first.
So you're a happy man?
Yes, it's very.
We fished for perch yesterday, just a little, like half a day. Caught one, caught 20 pike or something during perch fishing, so, which was good. But yeah, we wanted the perch. So today we'll be perch again. Hopefully we get them soon, and then we're back in the top of the leaderboards, and hopefully we can continue it and upgrade some fish. That's the game plan.
I catch a big perch. It's 52.4. It's the big one. And for the pike, I need more. And today I'm fishing pike only.
The first hour, try to upgrade the pike, and then go for the Zander and perch. We have two perch, so we have to need one perch, and we need three Zanders.
Hey guys, Sean here, representing Rebel Cell.
Brabazon is the leading company when it comes to lithium-ion batteries in the sport fishing industry in Europe. And Brabazon is also a proud partner of the Predator Tour in the Netherlands and in Sweden. I've been using the 24V 100, and on windy conditions like today, which was like 4 or 5 before, and yesterday it was even 6 with frost towards 7 or 8 before. A battery like this is essential. It will keep you powered through the entire day. And after a day like today, I got 46% left in my battery. I'm using the 24V 100 to power my Minn Kota Ultera, which is a 24-volt model, 80-pound thrust. And for the Solix, I got a Solix 10 in the front and a Solix 15 in the back. I'm using a 12V 100 to power them through the entire day.
So today it looked quite quiet, so my colleague has gone for a power nap, and suddenly something happened, but all the fishes are coming in, so it's quite busy at the moment with the inspection of the fishes. The participants are catching the fishes, they make a picture with the app, they check if it's correctly on the measure board themselves, but we do a recheck, and well, they send in the picture in, via the app, and we get it here for the rest of the inspection. Is it the correct size, the correct sticker, and for the measurement, of course. So that we could put it on the leaderboard and update the leaderboard immediately. The most made mistake, I'm not sure if we should call it the biggest, but they put the fish in the wrong side on the board. So we have a fish on the board, like here. Here's a fish, here it's his belly, same with this one. And also the fish of the picture should also be on this side. And sometimes they just turn the fish around. Yeah, that's not allowed. It should be belly down on the board, then it's okay. There are more fishing apps in the world, but I think this kind for this event, for the Predator Tour, is quite a unique app. People can watch in the app, they can see the leaderboard, they can follow their participants or even their favorite team, so they can see what's happening with their team and all that kind of stuff. So that's going quite well. And yeah, of course we're always updating the app to improve and make it better, make it easier to work with. Yeah.
Well, we are here in the harbor from the Kill. This is a club. We have about 219 places, and we are here on the biggest river point in the Netherlands. It's very wide, very wild, and sometimes, and excellent fishing water. Well, I'm harbor master here, and I try to organize every year that there are about 120 fishing boats in our harbor. I move people from the club to another place, and we try to get all the people together. And that's quite an organization, but for us it's a good event. And a lot of people from the city, they come to see and watch the boats leave. That's very nice. People stand on the bridge, and then in the morning the boats, they get the signal to go off, and then they go away with 100 kilometers an hour. Is very impressive to see.
The fish are biting slowly, but the pike came in the last minute. But it's a good day. We have a full card.
Unfortunately, we only could catch one big perch. We lost a couple, so it was a bit of a hard day. A little sore between the shoulders also, but still the motivation is 100%. So we'll be filling up our gas tonight, putting some juice in the batteries, and we'll be going out tomorrow again to get all the points and go for the extra 1,000 bonus points.
The fishing today was very good. We have full the card, and we are lucky that we back in the harbor.
What's the problem? You had some trouble yesterday, isn't it?
Yes, we have yesterday damaged the boat. We have a hole in the boat because the waves were very strong. We have today a new boat from a good friend, Daniel Kaczorek. We are very lucky we can fishing now.
I'm dropped 2-8 because many guys catch a fish. And the first and second catch three big fish today. The second catch 3 meter pike, and one yesterday and two today. And the first catch one big Zander, 94.5. And for us, it's terrible.
Good morning, everybody. Day three, final day. It's the excitement is on today. Why the excitement? If you see the leaderboard, it's just so close. It's like in the top five, it's centimeters. And the thing is, there is fish to choose from. What species will you aim for? What species will you upgrade? Is it the perch? Is it the Zander? Is it the pikes? Some teams are struggling, and some teams have a tough job for the upgrade to choose. Will you go for an upgrade of a pike that is already 1 meter one and aim for a 110? Will you improve the 30 centimeter perch to a 40 centimeter perch? That's the difficulty that the participants are here for on the last day. So if you want to see the winning team, if you want to see the leaderboard going up and down and up and down, just log in and feel the excitement. Well, tonight we know who will win Predator Tour 2019.
Yesterday we managed to get in the fourth position. Very, very proud of that. After really hard fishing. What I did yesterday was like a combination, because the weather was still good for pike. Klaas fished with bigger lures for pike, and if we came to a spot where I expect perch, I fished with smaller stuff, finesse style. And what I did was like, I have this new crankbait rod from Mike Iconelli, Abu Garcia of course, but it's Ike approved. Really sensitive twitching rod, so if I get more in the shallow, I use small crankbaits. And this is a very nice, I use it as a shed rod. So if you got deeper, I fish a little bit with sheds, with lead heads, so I can vary with the depth. So I always have these two in front of me, so I can switch. Shallower, crankbait, deeper, sheds.
We got the perfect start ever, yeah? We had to catch one small perch to get 1,000 bonus points and be on the tournament next year. And it took us 3 minutes. And we got this small little perch. It's whatever, 28 centimeters. Doesn't even matter for us.
Yeah? Unbelievable for us.
Yeah, for us it's perfect. We got this.
We started very handicapped in the tournament because our engine is broken. So we can only drive 11 kilometers per hour. So yes, we only drive here around and
we got our perch, 1,000 points next year.
One.
The fishing today, it's great. So we missed in the morning. We missed two perch. So we had no full cut, and it was very tricky. But we got the two perch.
Yeah, we try to upgrade now. We have a full cut, but pikes are 75 and 78, I think. So there's room to upgrade. We have 1 meter pike, but yeah. Maybe one around 90 would be great. I'm using a medium heavy rod, up to 50 or 60 gram. In this case, I use the Black Force series with a length around 2.30 meters. That's perfect for fishing from boat. And yeah, I always try to target all species, so with a 12 centimeter lure, I can catch a perch, but I also can catch big pikes or a nice zander.
Technically, I'm from France. I live in Ireland for 22 years now, and it's the same paradise like here. Water, fish, nice people, and good fun. We don't have zander, we don't have catfish, we don't have carp, but it's replaced by a very, very big pike, and we have very nice trout. They are called brown trout. They live in a lake. They come up to 1 meter 10 kilo. We have 12 bass boats, and we do everything for our customer. We collect them to the airport, we bring them at home. We have a fishing shop on site, we are licensed to sell the permits. So it's breakfast, we do lunch pack. Sometimes we do a shore lunch, you know, a hot shore lunch on the shore. We managed to win best restaurant in Northern Ireland last year. We are 7 years in a row best restaurant in Fermanagh in the county. So we are very proud of that.
So we started to power fish for big pike, but we didn't see any more of the big ones. We saw a lot of small ones. We upgraded 3 fishes. Yeah, in the long run, we caught some really nice fish, though, but they weren't enough. So, and we started to, how should I put it? The ghost of the perch started to hunt us. And this guy, when it was 12 minutes to go, he caught a perch. And that was amazing.
But that was really cool about it.
Yeah, he was really cool about it. I mean, the most amazing thing, actually, the perch itself wasn't that cool. I mean, it was a beautiful perch, but his reaction. Because one thing about fishing is that it's very emotional, very, very emotional. It's like a fucking roller coaster ride. And he was so focused for 2 hours. I mean, I could hardly speak. It was like electricity in front of the boat. He was saying, and then suddenly, I got one, oh! And I netted it. And then he started to go fucking crazy. I mean, literally fucking crazy. We fucking did it! And he did that for a couple of times. And that was so freaking awesome, man. And we had like a hugging polka in the boat, you know. A lot of emotions for this beautiful little perch.
But today we managed to catch the 3 perch we needed. And then in the end we needed just 1.2 centimeter for the first place. So we stayed on the perch and we could upgrade 1 centimeter more, but that was it, actually.
After we had the 3 perch, like Marcel told, we went on the perch because we were catching them after a row, and we thought there must be more, but unfortunately there wasn't more.
It ended up in the third place. The second place is only 3 millimeters, above us.
They are fucking bastards.
3 millimeters.
3 millimeters.
Yesterday we were in second place, and today the last plan it was to catch 2 big perch. and it was a very hard day for us. We catch only one big perch, it's a 47 perch, and we are in second place for 3 millimeters.
Today is very stress. We have bred 3 fish already, for 21 centimeter. Fantastic!
And Germany. Give them a big applause. Marcel and Niels. All the way from France, the Hernandez brothers, Kevin and Jordan. They were on the lead on day one. They were on the lead on day two. They are still on the lead. Light up!